The AirDrop works flawlessly between iPhones and Apple devices. It is a simple process to share files between Apple devices. But when it comes to iPhone and Windows PC, it isn't compatible. There is no such option like AirDrop for iPhones and Windows PC. Whenever you want to AirDrop any files between iPhones or Apple devices, it is a simple process. You just have to tap 2 or 3 times, then you will be able to share files over AirDrop using Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. And I will show you the same process where you can share files between iPhone and Windows PC within 2 or 3 taps after 1 time setup. For this process, we will use the Wi-Fi to share files between these 2 devices. Make sure both devices are connected to the same Wi-Fi network. Alright, now let's go to the Windows PC. Then menu and settings, network and internet option, Wi-Fi, then connected Wi-Fi network. Make sure the network profile type is set to private network. And then let's go back and advanced network settings, then advanced sharing settings. Now open private network and enable file and printer sharing. Now we need to create a shared folder on our PC. You can create the shared folder anywhere on your PC on any drive, but for this demonstration, I will create the shared folder on the desktop. Let's right click new folder. You can name the folder anything you want. I will name it as iPhone shared. Now right click on the folder and then go to properties, then sharing tab, click on advanced sharing and enable share this folder. Then click on permissions. Enable the full control to access and modify the files from any devices. Then hit apply and OK. Apply and OK again and close. Now search for CMD on your PC and open the command prompt. On CMD you have to type ipconfig, then press enter on your keyboard. Now you have to find the local IPv4 address of your PC, which is assigned by your router, the wireless LAN adapter Wi-Fi, and then IPv4 address. This is the local IPv4 address assigned by your router to your PC. We just need this local IPv4 address of our PC. But the problem is that the router might assign different local IP address after you restart your PC or reboot the router. For a stable connection, we can use the fixed IPv4 address for our PC. For this, go to menu again, then settings, network and internet option, Wi-Fi, connected Wi-Fi network, and then edit the IP assignment. Select manual IP, enable IPv4, and here you can assign the same IPv4 address, subnet mask and default gateway. So you can copy and paste or you can manually type it. I will assign the same IPv4 address, which is 192.168.29.81 in my case. In your case, it will be different. So you just have to assign the same IPv4 address, subnet mask and default gateway. And you also have to assign the preferred and alternate DNS on your PC. Here you can assign the Google's public DNS, which is quite faster and safer than your ISP's DNS. You need to type 8.8.8.8, then 8.8.4.4 and save the changes, and it will assign the Google's public DNS. So you can see that IPv4 address is the local IP and DNS Google's DNS. You can just browse the internet and verify if everything is working. Now we have a stable IPv4 address on our PC. One more thing, you need to find the computer user's name and password. In my case, the username is itechfever/pc. The password I know. If your PC doesn't have any password, you have to create a password first. Now let's go to the iPhone and make sure it is connected to the same Wi-Fi network. And then open the Files app. And then tap on 3 little dots at the top and connect to server. Now type the same IPv4 address which you assigned to your PC. In my case, it is 192.168.29.81. And then tap on connect and tap on registered user and then type your username and password, the PC username and password. Type the username exactly what you got on your PC. In my case, the username is itechfever.pc and then password, which you know, and hit next. Now it will connect to the shared folder on your PC. In my case, I have many other folders shared over network and the iPhone shared folder, which I recently created. Now let's try to share any file. Let's share this photo. Tap on share and then tap on save to files and tap on browse and find the shared option and your IPv4 address. Tap on it and select the folder where you want to save the file. In this case, iPhone shared folder, and then hit save. Now it will save the file on PC inside the iPhone shared folder. Let's open it. Now you see I got the file on my PC. So it is a one-time setup, then you can easily share files between your iPhone and Windows PC. Now let's try to copy any file inside this iPhone shared folder. Let's copy some random files. Copy and paste to the iPhone shared folder. Now let's check the iPhone. And if I go to the iPhone shared folder, you can see that I got those files which I copied on the iPhone shared folder on my PC. So let's open any file. This is the same file. And this is the file which I copied on the PC. So this way you can transfer files between iPhones and Windows PC. And there's one more benefit. You don't have to copy files every time. You can easily access any shared folder on your PC using your iPhone. Like I have shared the videos folder over the network. Now I can easily play any video from my PC on iPhone without copying it to the iPhone. Let's go back and check this folder. Inside this folder I have some videos and now I can easily play those videos. This way your iPhone won't take any memory and you can easily access the files from your PC. So this is more than file sharing, which you can't get from the AirDrop. Now every time you want to share any file from your iPhone to PC, you just have to open the file, tap on share and save to files. And now it will open that shared folder. You just have to hit on save. And your file will be copied to the PC. You can see that I got that file on the iPhone shared folder on my PC. So this way you can easily share files between your iPhone and Windows PC. Also, you can access any files from the shared folder on your PC using your iPhone. It is a one-time setup, but after that the process will be smooth and easy. This will work over the Wi-Fi and the hotspot as well. That's all for this video guys, hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos and I will see you in my next one.